We informed Kenyans that the Kenya Kwanza's economic proposals, policies and plans were unsound, unrealistic and unrectifiable.
As Azimio is that we condemn the budget and the finance bill in total.
Bado wanaongeza ushuru mwingine wa fuel levy kutoka 18% hadi 25%. Ushuru huu utaongeza gharama ya maisha, mawasiliano, kila kitu, mafuta yakienda juu, nauli, maisha ya kila mtu yatakuwa magumu zaidi.
We salute Kenyans who have used text messaging, phone calls and social media initiatives, hashtag find my MP, to urge their legislators to listen to their constituents and vote no. This peaceful civic assertiveness and engagement will eventually become the norm, especially under our leadership as your government in waiting.
Idris, I want to confirm that I have dispatched 86 letters to the 86 members of the National Assembly elected on ODM, and I'm sure my counterparts in the other affiliate parties are doing the same.
You cannot aspire and have the dream and the ambition to lead Kenya one day when you want to employ the tribal card.
Do not say during the day and seek to sabotage the same government that you are working in. Please be truthful, be honest.
Na wale viongozi, muambia kina Kimani Ichung'wah, chuma chao ki motoni. Waambie chuma chao ki wapi?
Ati wewe kwa sababu ni rafiki ya rais ati ukue bosi yangu. Even some people wanamsaidia kazi, mapie yake, wanataka tukuniamrisha mimi vile nitafanya kazi. Inawezekana? Hata bloga as ya president want to tell me what to do.
Usiongee mambo ya kuwa pamoja mchana. Na ikifika usiku, wewe ndio wa kwanza kutarangisha wengine.
Si mnanijua? Bosi yangu ni wangapi? Wananchi wa Kenya na President William Ruto. Whatever the president has told me to do, I have done. And I'll continue to do na kumheshimu na kuwa mwaminifu kwake.
Sisi tutasema tukiwa wa Meru Mount Kenya inamea wakati wa vita. Vita ikisha wakati wa kula inakuwa mlima. Wametuzoea. Tutasema kwamba hatutaki kuita Mount Kenya, tutataka kuita wa Kenya.
One man, one vote, one shilling. Hesabu ya kwanza ni kusema pesa ile mingi yende Nairobi. Hiyo ni kusema pesa ile mingi kabla ingia Kiambu. Number one ni Nairobi. Number two ni Kiambu. Number three Kakamega. Number four Nakuru na Busia. Nataka kuwauliza Wakenya hao wengine wataenda wapi.
Kama hapa Kasarani iko watu wengi, lazima wapewe pesa ya kutosha kufanya maendeleo. Pia kule Northern Kenya wapewe pesa yao. What you are just saying in simple terms is kila mtu apewe haki yake. Ausemi mtoto mwingine anyanganywe apewe mtoto mwingine.
Na Rigathi Gachagua aachiliwe afanye kazi yake. Hakuna deputy president mwingine Kenya amefanya ile kazi inafanywa na huyu mzee.
Watu wa Kirinyaga tunasemanga tuwezi tupa ng'ombe inakamuliwa tupate ndama ambayo haijazaa. Zingine ziko na mazoea kuharibika matiti unakosa maziwa.
Wale vijana tunao, wale hawana aibu. Vijana waki unakuta mpaka bunge, ndani ya bunge wanaleta matuzi ya kutuzi naibu wa rais.
Siku rais wetu ameona inafaa washikane na Raila Odinga, mimi nikajiuliza kama kiongozi nitakuwa mjinga kiasi gani kama yule Raila tulikuwa tunapiga Uhuru juu yake wameshikana na rais wetu. Hata mimi nikasema Uhuru ni wetu, ni mtoto wetu, aheshimiwe na tukae pamoja.
Na hatutaki rais aweke kwenye siasa ya misingi ya ukabila. Malaki kuna watu siku ya leo wameanza kugawanya wa Kenya kwa misingi ya ukabila. Na hata sio misingi ya kikabila peke yake. Hata hapa Mount Kenya region wameanza kugawanisha watu.
Ukisikia kitu ninasema ni ile ground inafanya nini? Ni ile ground inasema. Na mimi kama Rigathi Gachagua sina sauti yangu. Mimi naongea kwa niaba. Mimi naongeaga kwa niaba.
Commitment to peace makes certain fundamental concessions inevitable. This summit should not be a meeting of just friends. This should be a meeting of both friends and foe to succeed in this positive trajectory. Russia must be on the table.
Kwa nimetembea nchi nyingi kutafuta vile tunaweza kusukuma maendeleo ya Kenya. Na nimepanga marafiki wengi. Tuko na marafiki sasa wa World Bank, tuko na wa IMF, tuko na wa Marekani, tuko na wa China, tuko na wale wengine wote.
I want to see a day when Africa, the richest continent on the planet Earth, will be able to speak with one voice and ensure that our people get the rightful share of the wealth of this earth. We want to be able, we are not asking for charity. We are only asking for fairness in the international world market.
We have built a big reputation as a country. We have built friends. Some friends told me, how much do you want to pay? I said, I'm not ready to pay more than 20 million. They said, bring 10 million, we will give you the plane.
If you can finance period 2024, you excellency, mimi nataka kukuambia nikipiga no, ujue ni kwa sababu watu wamekataa, si mimi. Tenda huko subuki ya shrine, kwenda kutafuta divine intervention. Ndio siku ya Tuesday, niweke uamuzi kulingana na mapenzi ya Mwenyezi Mungu.
I am going to vote no on the basis of the suffering of Kenyans.
All right, might say it on the podium, but when it comes to, of course, going for the parliamentary group meeting, it's a different kettle of fish together. All together, will they really vote no? And it seems also Victor has captured it. Pass it all the same. This is everyone being whipped. As you can see, the tower of parliament is there. And looking and feeling the tone and tenor on the ground of how the Kenya Kwanza administration is right now with their parliamentarians, it seems there is a divided house. Will this really play out also in the passing of the finance bill? Are people listening to the ground, or it will be about their political party figure that will now have the say, or he will call out who is going actually to be voting or not, and how will that be having a repercussion on them as well? We saw last year as well that the finance bill, that was very contentious on the ground. People were standing in solidarity with the people, but when it came to voting as well, it was a different kettle of fish altogether. So how will this really pan out? Maybe just Dan Mazo and Okong'o Mugeni looking at this particular Dito cartoon. We have the deputy president there who is on a leash, as you can see. Honorable Raila Odinga, we've seen him also. He was commiserating with the country of Malawi with the passing of the vice president. He was speaking there. And he's sort of speak nonchalant as far as what is happening in the country is concerned. You, as a member of ODM, first of all, have you received the letter from Sifuna? As you heard from him saying that all members of parliament and the ODM party, they have received this letter. So I want to get confirmation from Dr. Nyikal and you. Have received the letter? Or what you're seeing here is just posturing?
No, you know, I hope you... there's a time I went to...
No, have you received the letter?
Send
that's the question. Not your hope.
I'm trying to give you an answer. But I'm going to give you an answer. Okay, let me see.
Or you want to say it, tell you first. It okay, came with a snail box. So.
You know, we don't vote for the finance bill. So the people who have received letters would be the members of National Assembly.
Okay.
But I wanted to give
for
you...
For the Senate, they don't, yes.
Senate, we don't. We don't vote on this.
But maybe it was sent en masse. So whoever is applicable, it will be applicable to them as well.
Yeah. Personally, I haven't... I don't need to be whipped. This bill.
It is no, it's not none of your concern. Dr. Nyikal?
I know a letter was sent. I got that over the weekend. I've not received it. But my position is clear. The position of the party is clear.
You've not received it?
No.
It was sent?
Yeah.
Was it sent in a PO box?
No, I'm not aware, but I
PO
know
box
that,
5-7.
I know letters have been sent. Email. Over the weekend, the letters I know were sent.
Okay.
And as I told you, I was not in Nairobi yesterday, so I believe it is somewhere. But I know the position of the party. I know that they've been sent. And we know that we're going to say no as things stand now.
All right.
There's no... I'm clear. We are clear on this. As a, actually, as a coalition, we are relatively clear on what this means. But let me say something, Dibar. I said earlier, to begin with, it doesn't even matter the content of the bill. Is it acceptable to Kenyans? It may be fantastic, but if Kenyans don't like it, it will be very difficult to implement. The lawyers here will tell you that any law which is unpopular is difficult to implement. People reject it. So on that basis alone, I think the best process is bring this bill down, the finance bill. If they think they have made enough amendments to make it good, let's have this one come down, fresh bill with those new considerations. We have gone through the public participation. The public didn't like it. If you are telling the public now, if we have done it, we are doing amendments, I don't know what they are doing in State House now, we may then say, well, let's give more time for the public again to consider those amendments you have brought. I don't think it will be the position of Parliament to say, now this is good, because there's also a requirement that if you amend a bill to a certain extent that actually changes what was originally there considerably until it's a new bill, then you should drop it completely and get a new bill. Mm-hmm. To that extent, as I sit here now, I know I'm going to say no. I know the party has said no. I have not received the letters, but I'm very confident they are on the way and I'll get mine.
I had some very flimsy idea that since 2016 we've not raised the fuel levy, so it should be raised to, from where it is right now, as it's 16% to 25%, and so running separately from the finance bill.
Yeah. I appreciate you, but you understand the constitution of Kenya. The moment I told you, as we don't vote for the finance bill, you said, okay, let me turn to Nikal. I was in an FM station, and somebody was asking, why are you waiting for MCS to impeach a governor? You should do it direct from Senate. And I was telling you, my friend, the constitution of Kenya has a way you do things. So if you want to impeach a governor, you wait for MCS to generate a motion of impeachment at the assembly, then they push it all through the Senate. And I was telling you, no, you can do it. You can just call this guy to Nairobi and you impeach him. And you know, I said, how can you, Kenyans be so ignorant? Yeah? Mm. So I'm impressed that you have picked it very quickly, and you understand that the framework, we have issues of budget are solely dealt with by National Assembly. Now, you know, I don't know where we are going with the taxation genuinely as a Kenyan. Because the last time I checked, taxes, how much is fuel per liter now? About 200.
It's about 100.
It's 170 something.
Now, imagine, no, it's 189, yeah, there, I think.
For the super electric, 76 shillings.
It's diesel.
Is taxes.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Yeah.
That's money that is not going into your car. It's just you are going to fuel, but the government is taking from you taxes, including the one they want to increase now. Road maintenance levy. When you fuel diesel, I think it's about 67 shillings. Just being taken away like that. On top of this, the current UDA administration again wants to give us motor vehicle circulation tax, which is a total misconception. You either have road tax, which is on a vehicle, or you have the road maintenance tax, because this tax is meant to maintain the road for you. The other taxes would be like what happens in London. You call it ULEX, ultra low emission zone, where you get punished to drive into the city with your vehicle. They are trying to have clean air circulation in cities. And before you do that, Dubai, you'll have provided alternatives to...
Dan Manzo, your mic is live.
Okay.
Your mic is live.
Yeah. You'd have provided alternatives to Kenyans. So, you know, there must be a limit. I saw the Catholic bishop. Is it? He's called Muhere.
Archbishop
Muhere. You know, he was telling the president, Kenyans can't breathe anymore. Mm. You are choking Kenyans with taxes. And they said, let's be frank with you. In my county of Nyamira, if a bishop tells me something, I freeze when a bishop is speaking, because they just come in to speak for the poor and for the people and for an issue that they really feel is very oppressive to the people. So if you add the fuel levy, you increase it by 9 shillings, it means it will move from 76 to around 87.
I think that what they're doing is they're moving it from 18 to 25. Mm. And that has come from the road levy, and that has come from Minister Mukomen.
Yeah.
Outside the finance.
Yes.
And, but the fuel levy.
Remember. Remember, that is not the only tax.
Mm. Yeah.
You know, you have the railway tax. I think there is VAT.
On
is
it.
There is import declaration. Mm. There are about 5 taxes. So if you increase it, it will take up that figure from 77 to around 80.
They're
increasing by how many shillings?
This one, this is from 18 to 25, so 7 shillings.
So you can add, if it's 76 plus
8,
that goes to 84. The fuel on the pump will automatically shoot up, and it will have a trickle-down effect on basic commodities. Because fuel has an immediate impact on everything, transportation, the price of essential commodities, etc. So that even opens another avenue. When Kenyans are busy crying about the finance bill, there's another hidden tax. Because that's again a tax on Kenyans. So where does this UDA administration want to take Kenyans, honestly? Where what will be the end game to this? First financial year, increased taxes. The first budget, increased taxes. Second budget, increased taxes. You know, I wonder to wonder, if Ruto was to go back for a second term, how many taxes will Kenyans pay? Because he's doing it now, and he knows that in another 2 years, we are going to face an election. Even the British, the Conservatives, are very careful because they know there is an election coming. Mm. They are saying we are not raising any taxes. You move down to Australia, Anthony Albanese was just taken over from Scott Morrison. He's doing his first term and he's very careful. His budget is telling Australians we are not going to increase taxes. But I'll go to the bigger question, Dubai. Even as UDA increases taxes, what are the social benefits we are getting as Kenyans? Because countries that tax people so much, they also give back to the people so much. If you go to Australia, if you give birth, you get a baby, they call it a baby bonus of 5,000 Australian dollars. You give back to one baby, you get paid 213 Australian dollars. You get another, if it's twins, you'll be getting 500 Australian dollars every month. The government is taking care of you. You go to health facilities, the Medicare card works. Doctor, you know it. Mm. You go to an hospital for an emergency, you'll be treated. In a government hospital, you'll be treated. You're going for delivery, you'll be treated in a nice, clean environment. Your baby will be given vaccines in a very clean environment with specialized doctors. What are we getting in return? You go to Britain, the transport infrastructure. You know, even if you tell Britons that we are going to charge you for driving into London, you have given them an alternative, Dubai. If you're in central London, Tottenham Lane will take you direct to Heathrow, any of the gates. You don't need to drive your car. You just enter there and it will throw you there. You are back in the city. If you have a child going to school, if it's Umoja, you know that the bus, public transport, not these matatus, public transport will pick your child at 7. And there will be a signpost there telling you the next bus is coming at 7:15, the next one is 7:30. So you feel that the government is giving you service. You don't need a car because the alternatives that are there are adequate. This thing that moves in the city is called a tram.
Tram.
The tram. If you don't need to use a bus, the tram is there. Now, in Kenya, what is there to show from the government? What service are you giving to Kenyans? I have a situation where a child was taken to Tenuek Hospital. They tried to present the NHIF card. They were told it's not working. That child is detained in Tenuek Hospital. And the government is not bothered. Nobody's coming in for these poor families. So as you tax us, Libar, the question I want Kenyans to ask themselves this morning, what social support services are we getting from the government of the day? You know what's happening with university education? Mm. Day school children who used to pay 6,000 and then they get that feeding program, that is collapsing. Parents are now being told to pay up to 20,000 shillings for that school feeding support program for the scholars. So you cannot be piling taxes on Kenyans, while on the other hand, there's nothing to show for it, Dibar. We must say as Kenyans that there is a level where we draw a red line and tell the government, beyond this, it is too much. A teacher last Saturday played some game on phone, you know, because there is no money, you know. He went to play a game and
he lost
50,000 shillings.
Committed suicide.
Do you know what? He committed suicide. That's where we have reached as a country. So the bottom line, Dibal, is that the likes of Murkomen, who the other day was a representative of the people as a senator, should be conscious that there is a level beyond which Kenyans cannot stomach it anymore. And the money that we are giving to government in form of taxes on our fuel, 76 shillings, is enough. I urge our colleagues in the National Assembly to have a bipartisan approach. Maybe you need to take these guys into a lecture and talk to them. You know, they behave as if they don't live.
They're being lectured now, as we are talking.
Now they're being lectured to come and hit Kenyans with more taxation. But beyond there, I'm telling you, beyond there, we are going to make this a very unattractive jurisdiction for anybody to do business. I think already on pay, we are the highest in East Africa. Mm. Because our highest is 32.5%. All the others are at the highest of 30. So if you make everything too expensive, investors will take off. Yeah? You saw what's happening to this guy used to be in Parliament, Medhill Hospital. Mm. He has been auctioned in Eldoret.
He's been auctioned?
Mm. Yes. Mm. He has been auctioned in Nairobi. He has been auctioned in Nakuru.
The former MP of Kisses?
Yes.
Yeah.
Medhill. And how many people, Nikali, you can disclose, how many people are working in that facility who have become jobless?
He had a number of actually hospitals.
You can imagine, all those Kenyans are now jobless. And I've not seen anything in the budget saying the government's going to caution people whose businesses are going through some distress. In the U.S. budget, Biden has put in $20 billion to cushion Americans who may be facing eviction for defaulting on rent and the likes, because you must support businesses so that you don't have all these youths who are out there unemployed. Is there anything in our budget that is supporting the business people, the hustler, who is in distress? Nothing. All we want is just to milk this cow. I saw that cow there. We just want to milk that cow, you know, but we don't want to take care of the cow. It's a very unfortunate situation. I don't know how Kenyans view. You know, I'm imagining I'm a mama mboga, I'm a boda boda. I was convinced. I listened to Ruto saying, I have a plan for you. And I walked into a voting booth and voted for him. What do you think is going through the minds of those Kenyans? They feel cheated.
Totally. Right. Let's take a short break. We run our commercials as well. We pay our bills. And when we circle back, Dan Mazu, this frosty relationship that is happening in the Mount Kenya region, how do you see it playing out in tomorrow's debate or today's debate, whichever way it goes, in regard to the finance bill, right? Will you get also support you as Wiper Kenya? We have ODM as well that will have numbers. Or if they're whipped today, then it seems also the tyranny of numbers will work against you as well. Well, we take a short break. You're watching Siasa's Fiesta. Let's just pay our bills.